Okay, now it's recorded and we just start today with Apache Scoop. So what is Scoop? Any idea?
Yeah, basically Scoop we use to store that RDBMS data in SDFS.
Okay.
Scoop is an ETL tool.
Okay.
Just to inject the data.
Okay. Why directly we can do in some other tools, right?
Data platform, the direct tool called Scoop as injection tool.
Correct. So we can inject the data. Let's say, for example, I have a data in RDBMS. I just convert as a file and directly inject into the Hadoop environment, right? That is possible, right? Then why Scoop is needed?
Come again, Dinesh.
If you want,
I have, let's say, for example, in my MySQL or Oracle or SQL Server, I have a table, right? I just convert that as a file, and that file I can directly inject into the Hadoop environment. That is possible, correct?
Yes.
Why we have to go with Scoop? This kind of task only Scoop is doing, right?
So yes. The thing is, like, every time you need to inject, you have to convert that file and then put into HDFS.
Okay.
But I think we can append that file by using that Scoop.
Okay, so close to current. So it helps to making automation in and interact with your RDBMS environment. So in Scoop, you can see here, this one. This one, Scoop is available, right? This Scoop is going to be interact with your Hadoop. It should be one side is Hadoop, another one side is should be in RDBMS. So the data, once you can inject via Scoop to Hadoop environment or reverse operation from Hadoop to inject to RDBMS. It's like a importing or exporting operation you can do via Scoop only. Okay. So Scoop is nothing but SQL plus Hadoop. That's a short name for Scoop. So it should be structurized query language like RDBMS only. You can follow with your Scoop operation. Clear?
Yes, Dinesh.
So in Scoop, so these are the database will be supported. Scoop is a Hadoop component built on top of HDFS. So HDFS in the top layer, we will be followed everything with MapReduce concept. That MapReduce we can achieve via Scoop operation. Okay, till now the projects are mostly using with Scoop also. If that data will be in multiple sources, if it is relational databases, they mostly go with Scoop injections, because this is very easy, and while injecting the data, you can make it as automations. That's the reason Scoop still used. But the competitor tool is available, Talend, and you can use for Knife also, you can do that. But here that Scoop, one more advantage is called incremental operation. It's like append data. Yesterday data is, I have received 10,000 records. Today I'm going to receive 2,000 records. It's just going to be refer where the 2,000 record only is available. That record only you can filter and store it here. Likewise, Scoop is possible. So the Scoop shell is mostly you will be going to work with a normal terminal itself. You don't want specific any interactive shell. It's not required. Clear? Any question?
No.
So directly in that our environment, right? You just open a terminal, you can use Scoop, and then you can use Scoop command. Directly it will be work. So these are all the database will be supported by Scoop. MySQL, Oracle, SQL Server, PostgreSQL, and etc. So Scoop, before you are going to work with the Scoop, you have to follow three key points. So whether it should be a support with import or export, and then it should be followed with any RDBMS Java compatible. if that RDBMS tool will not be support for Java compatible, then you cannot achieve it. Example, SQLite. It's a small RDBMS tool that is not have that compatible with your Java. So that RDBMS, you can interact. So what are the database that will be interact via Java, Java compatible, so Java based JDBC connections. That only you can achieve via Scope. Because Scope in the backend will be using MapReduce concept. So MapReduce and the entire Hadoop will be followed with Java. So JVM framework. Okay, so Hadoop is backend, they will be using Java framework only. That's the reason they will be upgrade the Java from 7 to 8 right now for Hadoop 3x version. Are you clear, guys?
What you said that Java 1.8, didn't understand that.
Hadoop 2x will be support for Java 7. Hadoop 3x version will be support only in Java 1.8. Clear?
Yes.
So that JDBC jar they have using as a connector here, which will help to interact with this, our Hadoop environment via Scope. So that jar you have to load it. So this is the major three key points you have to follow. Any question? You know, right? What is jar means? Just some MySQL connector or something. It's like a connector jar will be used. Shall we go next? Any doubts?
Yeah, what is a jar, Dinesh? Actually, I'm not getting.
It's a library.
Library, okay.
Yeah, that's it. It's a Java library that we are going to use it.
Okay.
Nothing, you're not doing that. You just copy that file, that library, and paste into this library part. That's it. Automatically, it will be making some interactions. Okay?
Yeah, okay. I got.
Let's say I'm going to work with MySQL, then I am going to store that MySQL libraries to this environment. If I'm going to work with MSSQL, then I need to store that MSSQL library like that. So just you want to copy the library and paste it, because it's based on the versioning. MySQL 5 point something version will be followed with different library. 8x version will be followed with different library. Oracle also will be working 12c in different library. 18c will be working with different library. So based on that versioning, you have to store that library file also. Then only it's going to be called. So in the backend architecture, how it will be going to work means we have architecture like this. So this is the architecture. Here you can see, right? So what is the query will be received? Scope can identify and will be making with that connectors. This connector is nothing but your JVM. So JVM is going to be referred with metadata, and I will tell you what is metadata repository. During that incremental operation at the time, I will tell you the steps. Okay, so once it will be, it have that connector and metadata references, then it's automatically going to Hadoop environment and convert as a map task. So map task, what will be doing? It's going to be interact with your RDBMS based on your JDBC connection and fetching the data, and it will be stored into Hadoop environment. Okay. So in Scope, everything you have to follow with mapper only. What is the reason behind? Anyone? Whatever query you'll be shoot via Scope, that will follow only with mapper.
Basically, what it says that the query that we can fire from Scope architecture is basically select star from something like that.
Okay.
We can't make aggregated queries.
Okay, like say I have to get the count of value. Okay. So I'm going to shoot the query with the select count from the table. So will it require for reduce?
Yes.
Are you sure? My query is, I'm going to use it, that's called a freeform query. I am going to get the data, select count from table. That is my query. I am going to show.
No, I think it won't call MapReduce job.
It will call MapReduce. Yeah, tell me. Will it require reduce operation?
If there is a where clause or a group by or something like that.
Whatever, select count start. Okay, I have an employee data set, right? Select department comma count of employee from employee table group by department. This is the query I'm going to shoot it.
Yeah.
So this query I'm going to shoot into the RDBMS environment, fetching the data. So how many mapper will run and how many Redis will run?
Mapper, it will depend upon the size of the data.
Okay. So Redis, you are getting my question, right? All of you? Still any confused? I am going to load the data from RDBMS. That data is a summarized output. That data I'm going to store into Hadoop environment. Okay. So in RDBMS, I have 1 million of records available. That's employee table. So based on the department wise, I'm going to summarize the output for employee account. That's my query. I'm going to shoot it. How many mapper and how many reducer will be run? Mapper depends on your size of the data, okay, as you understand. So, will reducer will be functioning there or not?
I think it will be map only task.
Why? That is I am expecting from you.
Yeah. If you have more mappers, then reducer will come into the picture. So since we are having a less size of mappers, I think the reducer mapper itself will display the result.
Come again, I am not clear.
So since we have a less mapper, I think reducer will not come into the picture.
Why?
So this, what is the query you told? Sorry for interruption.
Sorry, voice is breaking.
What is the query you?
Select department comma count of employee from employee table group by department. This is the query I'm going to shoot. That record I'm going to
it will have a reduce. It will use reduce function.
Okay, I will tell you the answer. It will not request it for the reducer. The reason behind, you are shooting the query, right? Select, count, everything. That is going to be worked with your RDBMS engine, not for your Scoop engine. Directly, this query is going to be shoot and fetching that output. That output, whatever, that only mapper will be fetching out. Because that is whatever you'll be shooting that freeform query, right? Select, count of the value. Everything will be followed with your SQL engines. If it is Oracle, Oracle engine will be shoot and fetching the data. That final output only you are going to fetch via your MapReduce operation. So it's like a structurized some output, it's a summarized output. So that is not required any reducer part. It just transfer the data. So whenever you are doing any aggregation via MapReduce itself, then only the data, if let's say for example data is available in Hadoop environment, at the time map and reduce will be functioning with your Hadoop environment. But here what I'm doing, my query is, I just provide the query as a client. This query will come here. This query is going to be shoot in your RDBMS environment. You're getting my point? That table is available in RDBMS. It just shoot and fetching the data. Based on the data, it's just going to be injected into Hadoop environment. So here it will be providing the 100 records as output. That only will be fetching via MapReduce. So mapper is going to be fetch the data just to transfer it. You will not be using reducer part.
So Dinesh, the number of mapper we need to give more, it will automatically take the mappers.
Default 4 mapper will be functioning. If needed, you can change more than that or less than that also.
Okay.
So number of mapper will be created as number of files. That's it. Default four mapper means if you are going to shoot the query here, it just going to be create four mapper and split it. Let's say for example, I have 1,000 record in RDBMS. I am going to transfer those record as a file to Hadoop environment. Then the mapper is going to be work with your RDBMS and slice each as 250 records, and each file will be stored as a 250 records of one file. Like four file will be created. Otherwise, if I need to store as a single file, that is also possible. Based on that, you can do it.
So you're saying while importing, the reducer is not required. Only for exporting, we need a reducer.
Exactly.
Okay.
Clear? Any question? That metadata I will tell you during that incremental operation. That's based on the jobs, everything will come at the time I will tell you. It just holds about that your data information. It's like a metadata only. But how it is loaded and everything I will tell you at the time. Because at that time we cannot visualize it. Guys, are you clear with the architecture? Shall we go next?
Yes, Dinesh.
Others?
Yes, we can go next.
Yes, Dinesh.
So in scoop command will be followed with this only. Scoop tool name or tool argument, and then generic argument there will be followed. So to scoop, you can use it for code gen, mostly you'll be using export, import, import all tables, list databases, list tables. These are the command you'll be using. So directly you can see, this is the shell mode only you can use it. So simply you're just mentioning as a scoop, and if I'm going to use it import or export, then it will be performing with that only. Okay? If I'm going to import the data, you have to mention like import. So based on that, this is a tool argument. Based on the tool argument, it's going to be work with your generic argument. Let's say, for example, I'm going to import the data from RDBMS. What is the connectivity I need to provide? What is the username, password? Which table I'm going to locate? Where I have to store in Hadoop environment? Which directory? These are all with respect to your import, right? So that import is called tool argument. That connectivity, table name, all the information will be provided as options. That is called a generic argument. Both you have to provide, then only it will be connected. Are you clear, guys?
So these are the command mostly be used in scoop, right?
This is for import or like that only. I will tell you the command. This is a sample. Okay, better we'll go with some example, then you'll get some idea. Okay. So here you can see, I'm going to list what are the databases available into that our database. I'm using MySQL, right? So the based on the MySQL, I'm going to execute this command and fetching that information via our MapReduce operations. Scoop, list databases, and then I'm using connect. So connectivity always I said is a JDBC, and MySQL connectivity I'm going to use it. And with respect to username and password. So these are all the information I have to provide. Then only this scoop is going to be connect via this JDBC connection, and it's going to be get the access via your username and password and fetching this information. Likewise for table of one particular database, then it's possible via list tables. Okay, it's like a generic code they will be developed. You're going to use it, that's it.
So once we import this database, where it will store finishing HTTPS will store or default, is there any default location something like
that? I will show you one by one. You have some idea, right? I just give you some basic idea, then I will go with your where it will be stored everything one by one.
Okay,
we'll see some small hands on right now. Then you will get some clear picture. So there we have seen some command, right? Scope, list databases, connections, and everything I have to provide. Just a minute, just hold up. Oh, unfortunately, not responding. Just copy it. So simply I'm going to execute. Something wrong. So scope list databases. I just opened the terminal. Scope list databases --, connect, and this code is not available. This is the code, actual double quote. You have to use it. So just provide the command here fully. Username as root. Password also will be root. Correct?
Yes.
I'm just going to open our MySQL. MySQL -, user as a root. Password also root. I'm going to use it. Now I'm going to see that database details. So these many databases available in our MySQL DB. Okay. The same I'm going to retrieve via our scoop job. Okay, now you can see output information schema, Airflow, BDB project, and demo, Hive, everything same is available. Okay, you got it. So now what you are doing, this is the command is going to be execute via scope to MySQL DB and fetching this record from MySQL engine that will showing to you. This is happening in backend. Clear?
Yes, so, Dinesh, from where it is getting connected? I mean, where you have kept the jar? In what location?
Scoop geolocation only.
So Dinesh, we need to use this SQL connector, right? So
1 minute, I will show you the jobs. Here you can see, this is a MySQL connector job.
So whatever the database is required,
that jar we have to include here. That's it.
Okay.
Guys, you are getting right. This is the jar.
Yes. So,
something we have to load. I just mentioned you before. So, scoop library, scoop home library, that Java compatible jar we have to load. So, this is the jar .jar file. This is I have loaded. It is should suitable with your MySQL version, because a lot of the jar they will be generated based on the new versioning. So if it is a major version will be in same, then it will be work. If it is mismatched, then it will not be work to you. So be careful about this. Already I have loaded for the time practice. You can create some table in MySQL. You can inject it.
Okay. If I want to use Oracle, then I need to add jar for that one, right?
Yeah, exactly. Oracle jar, you have to use.
Okay.
So that's an important, right? That is the connector via that MapReduce is going to function. I just load it, right? Good. Any question? Now you have some idea, I guess.
Yeah, data for so databases, there is no file is created, right? Means so no mapper is running.
Yeah, 1 minute. Okay, come again, your question.
Yeah, for that so database there is no files created, right?
Yeah, no files will not be, we will not be mention any file directory, right? Only if you are going to import, then only it will be doing these things. Okay. And also why you need this file information? The database information is not required, right? As a file, because it's a one time only.
Yeah, okay.
So it's not required. Guys, are you clear? Still any confused? Any question, please bring it to me. We will discuss. This is the basic that I have tried. Okay, so likewise, I am going to fetch the particular table for the particular database of tables. What are the tables available in the particular database that I am going to use it? Use. We can take as MySQL. Show tables. So this 20 tables is available in MySQL DB, right? So they same we are going to see via this form. Instead of databases, I'm going to locate tables. Correct? And then in this JDBC connection itself, you have to mention database name. I am going to use this as a MySQL database, correct?
Yeah, every time need to provide that username and password, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is a MySQL. I have used to the MySQL. In this MySQL DB, I have this many tables. That is, I am going to retrieve here. So JDBC, MySQL, --, username, --, password, I just provided. Correct? List. Tables is a command. So show all the tables into this MySQL DB. That is the command I just trying to execute it. Okay. So what are the tables available? We are going to connect via our scoop and fetching those information and showing to you.
So here mapper not create,
Dinesh. Yeah, here you are just connected and fetching the data. So that's not required mapper. Mapper, whenever you'll be running with your Hadoop environment, you'll not to store any data in Hadoop, then mapper is not required. Correct? Just JDBC as a generic jar is going to work for you and fetching this information.
Okay.
If it is data is going to be injected into Hadoop environment, at the time only that mapper is needed. Or if you are going to read the data from Hadoop, that also time also required for some map. It's just going to be fetch that basic information via JDBC, scoop JDBC. You will not be using, you will not include any Hadoop environment details here. Correct?
Yeah, correct, Dinesh.
You're getting the point, right? That's what I'm expecting. Because mainly I have tried and why I go with architecture. Without hands-on, the scoop will not be understood immediately. You have some idea. That's an overview you need. That's what first day itself, with I just started with hands-on. Because this understanding is a little kind of difficult. All of you, if you are clear, then we go for further things.
Clear, Dinesh.
Any question, others?
No.
Savita, Vishal.
Yes, clear, Dinesh.
Thank you. So now, till now, we have seen how to retrieve the data from database as well as table via scope. That's it we have seen. Now we just trying to inject some data into our Hadoop environment. Okay, and evaluation query. This is also will not be interacting with your Hadoop environment. That is called evaluate. So already I said, right, you are going to shoot the query and fetching the data. That kind of work will be following with this evaluate. So what kind of data is available? That information you can get via this evaluate. Better I can create one table database. Create database, a demo. Already there, it's got one, okay. Use demo underscore one and create table in EMP ID as int, name as string. Okay, create table, table name. Correct.
Name will be worker.
Oh, string is not considered, right? Correct. Create table, table name, and then I just mentioned, check the syntax question, message question, the right syntax is near to. So.
Don't leave space between the table name and the bracket, Dinesh.
Okay, so this is an example. Name, back arrow, some value you have to provide, that's an important. One minute. Okay, I don't have any data right now from EMP. I'm going to insert the record. Insert, anyone tell me the command? How to insert the record?
Insert into table name, values, bracket, give the value like.
You are saying the answer, so I just mentioned your name. Okay, one record was inserted. Second, like, push pin drop. Third record, Bishar. Fourth record will be Savita. Now I just going to retrieve this table. Okay, this is the record I have. So this same query I'm going to shoot via scoop and fetching the data. So scoop, evaluate, and that whatever we have, right? Connections, username, password, everything we can use it. So same only we will be using here. And then we have to mentioning that query as well. Hyphen hyphen query. This is should be that query. Okay. So scope, evaluate, connections, query. So this query is going to be shown that it's going to fetch that record and show it to you. Username and password. Something missed. It's not in MySQL, right? Demo underscore one database. Correct? Demo underscore one database. Okay. So now it's trying to be interact with your environment and fetching this information. Just first we have seen what are the databases available, and then we have seen what are the tables available, and then we have seen how what content of the tables available. Clear?
So in this command also the mapper will not create, Dinesh.
I am not getting. Come again.
No, in this query also the mapper will not create, right?
You are not going to store any record into Hadoop environment. So until you are not touching your Hadoop, it will not be execute any map and reduce. These are all JDBC interaction via Java code. That's it.
Okay.
You're getting right.
Yeah.
This is you are going to connect via Scoop, but it's a JVM interaction. Java code only is working. Whenever you're going to store or retrieve the data, at the time only your map reduce will be work.
Okay.
Okay. So this select whatever is written within query will be executed in the RDBMS side.
Yeah. Exactly. Now let's say, for example, I'm just going to execute count. So total 4 records available. Only 4 you will get as an output. Okay. Just to shoot the query and fetching the data. Clear? This query is shoot in your RDBMS engine. This only output is 4, right? This is the record you are going to fetching via Scoop. Guys, any question?
No, Dinesh.
So now only we just enter into import statement. In this import statement, you can interact with your Hadoop environment.
So Dinesh, before going to Scoop import, can we also perform join?
Yeah, that is also possible. Okay. If you have table, then you can use a join. That final output only, that summarized output only you're going to fetch out, right?
Okay.
So that's not a problem. Whatever that query is going to be executed in RDBMS environment. Only that output is going to be fetched out by our scope. Okay, so all the functionality will be available. Clear? Any other question?
Yes. So
Scoop import you can use like Scoop space import or Scoop hyphen import, and generic argument asset connector, table name, everything you can provide. And import argument is like where you have to store in Hadoop environment, how many mapper you want to run, everything you can mention as an import argument. Okay, so this is two you have to provide it. This is a sample code, Scoop import connect, and you can provide that RDBMS connections, and then the database name and username, as well as if you are mentioning as an iPhone caps P at runtime only you have to provide the password. If you are using as a iPhone small p or iPhone password, then you have to provide in the console at directly as a single query. Otherwise it will ask you the password at runtime. That is the use of this one. Okay. Here you can see I am just using, right? Instead of that, that password is secure. I just mentioning as iPhone P. Okay, so like this I'm providing Scoop, evaluate, connect, username, query, and then username as root, password I just providing as a secure. So I will not be disclosed in terminal. Now I'm going to execute it. Now it is asking about the password. What is the password? So you can provide your password as root, then only just connected and fetching the data. Okay, it's like a console credential. Whenever you can, you have a very secure connections password, then you don't want to share it. At runtime, you can provide. Clear? That is the use of hyphen cap. So, and then CAPSP, which table you are going to import into your environment, how many mapper is needed. This mapper you can mention hyphen M, otherwise you can mention hyphen hyphen num mappers. Likewise, you can mention. And target directory, which Hadoop environment you are going to store the file, as well as fields terminated by. While storing the data, fields terminated by. While storing the data, how the data will be delimited. That information you can provide via this field terminator. By default is comma. If you are not declare anything, if need anything different, then you can mention this. Okay, now we can see with small hands on, then you will get some clear picture. So I'm going to use scoop import, and these are all the generic argument. Okay. Query right now is not required. I will tell you about the text file. Directly, I just locate the table. Table as employee, right? And username as root, as well as password also root. These are all generic arguments. Clear? Till now, you're clear?
Yes, Dinesh.
Okay. So, scoop import connect. Table name, username, password you provided, and then where you are going to store it. Hyphen hyphen target hyphen directory. So now I am planning to inject the data into DFS hyphen LS. / user big data area. BDP April, okay, scoop is available. Scoop. Okay, few is available already for the previous batch, I think so. Better I can do. I will create a new directory. Scoop _ APR 2020. All your scoop operation I'm going to inject into this environment. Okay, this is the actual directory. In there, I'm going to create each one. Target directory as this directory of subdirectory as a single mapper. Okay, and then hyphen hyphen num hyphen mapper as one I just declared. Which means while running, you just take only one mapper to perform this operation. That is the use of hyphen hyphen num mapper. Okay.
So will it not be decided on the runtime depending on the data size?
It will be identifying and creating as only one file. Number of mapper equal to number of files in scope. I'm going to create as a single file, right?
Okay.
Okay.
If you don't give one, then default will take it as a 4, right?
4, right, it will take. Okay. There also some criteria is available, I will tell you. Hyphen hyphen num hyphen map, right? Mappers. Now you can see this is created as a job. and you can see the number of mapper now. The map reduced. Okay, mapper will be start. Number of mapper variable. Okay, number of sprites is equal to 1. Okay, mapper 100% was completed. In this table, only 4 records available, right? That information you can give. These are all some map reduce operation information. This time you are going to interact with your Hadoop environment, so that number of map and reduce will be created and executed. Clear?
Can we import it to Hive location directly?
Whatever you have in the Hadoop, on top layer only you will be using Hive, right?
Yeah.
So you can use it as an external table, simple.
Okay.
So already I have created one directory. There I am going to open it. So another one directory is available. Single mapper. Just before it was created by SDFS DFS-LS of this directory.
Dinesh, how to configure the scope in a standalone system, Dinesh?
Already it was configured in our environment. You can try.
And I'm just asking if you have any system. So I need to configure a scoop manually. So it's like we need to have Hadoop first, or without Hadoop we can install the scoop.
It should follow with Hadoop only. Without Hadoop it will not be work.
Okay.
What I
mean? Can you give us that details as in how you have installed the, all these Hadoop, Hive, Scoop and all?
That I will share you, but that have the basics of Hadoop concept and Hadoop installation, admin installation part. Already have tried some installation part in Linux and Roma, then fine. Otherwise, you'll get some bottle. I will share you, but you can try from your own.
Okay.
It's a little difficult, that's what I'm saying.
Dinesh, actually, I tried in Windows system and Linux, but I'm not sure about VM. VM also, same thing.
You just try, the same only. If it is Hadoop is working in Windows environment properly,
yes,
then you can try with Scoop also. No issues. Mostly it will be creating the temp caches and it will not be following any replications properly in the Hadoop environment. You will get some impact, but you can try for the practice. But the reality, you have to go only with Linux. That's an important.
In Linux, I tried to configure the scoop in my office, but I'm not able to configure. That's what I was just asking.
Okay, the same step only you can do it. But okay. I'm not sure supporting batch script is available or not. That is unimportant. Because everything in Windows environment .bat file will be used.
Here so in my office, we have Ubuntu and I tried in Ubuntu, Dinesh.
1 minute. I'm not sure whether it is working or not. You just try. CMD file is available. I think it will work. I think so, but I'm not sure. You just try. Because dedicatedly Hadoop environment should be for Linux. That's the dedication scheme provided. But if you need it, you can do. Okay, so come back to this one. Forgot about these things. So SDFS, DFS, cat, and then you can provide the pod file, right? Whatever the Hadoop is going to be created, that should be a pod M, and then it will be providing 4.0. What is the meaning by for this? Any idea?
Index value.
Sorry, what, Dinesh?
Why this file name always comes like this? What is the reason behind?
Index value, Dinesh. Is that the index value?
partition.
Okay. And then
M for mapper.
Number of partition.
Mapper partition of zero. Mapper partition of one. That is the meaning it will be creating like this. Whatever you will shoot into Hadoop environment, always will be creating part hyphen M hyphen 0000. Then the next file will be 0001. The last one value only will be new file will be created and stored like that. So partitioned data with mapper operation that will be splitted and stored as well, 0 index to number of. Always will be start from 0. Okay, so now that RDBMS, that employee table, that will be moved into our Hadoop environment. Okay, now it is available in this directory. Got it? Like this, you can transfer the data from MySQL or any RDBMS to Hadoop environment. Now it's properly injected. On top layer, you can do any other else. Clear?
Large set of data can be done with Scoop. For example, if you have like 10 GB or 100 GB of data.
Whatever, you can achieve via Scoop.
Okay.
So based on that, the number of partitions will be modified. And while storing the data, you can go with some that append operation. That is also possible. Like that, you can achieve it. Or you can do via each record will be 1,000 records or 10,000, whatever, right? Like evaluate query, you can mention record and fetching those information. That is also possible. Okay.
Dinesh, can we import CSV file to HDFS by using Scoop?
ESP, you said as a file. So file object directly you can do via HDFS put comment.
Okay, we can't do via Scoop.
Only RDBMS table only you can inject via Scoop. That is, I said, right, one site should be in RDBMS, another site should be your Hadoop environment.
Okay.
Guys, any question? Are you clear?
Yes, Dinesh. So suppose if I have given the number of mappers as, I mean, if it is a default, then I would be expecting 4 files, right? The part, the partition.
4 files. If need, you can go with 10 files also. It is possible.
Okay.
So that are all we can see by tomorrow. Okay. One by one, I'll go.
Okay.
Till now, any questions? This, any doubts?
Dinesh, can we integrate the Scoop with Spark?
Yeah, possible. But it depends. Mostly Scoop integration with Spark, they will not be doing like that because it will be locked that memory also, right? A lot of memory will be locked. But possible. Scoop library, they will be used in Spark. They can do it.
Okay.
Anything else? Others? Krishnendra, Sabita, Vishal. I think no, right? And if no question, we can write it today.
Okay. Yeah, I do.
Yeah, any question?
No.
Okay, guys. Thank you. We'll connect tomorrow and go with further.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dinesh.